I'm Dr. Eleanor Martin, Assistant Professor in the University of Oklahoma's School of Meteorology. Today I'll be discussing the impacts of climate change on ocean circulations. Ocean currents have many profound impacts, including on marine life. It is well known that plankton drift with currents, and many large animals drift when they are young. For example, sea turtle hatchlings often drift and are carried by the currents for long periods of time. Strong swimmers, such as an adult whale, are also impacted by currents, which may carry them off course. Even terrestrial species, such as tortoises and lizards, can be carried by currents to colonize new areas, often rafting on debris, such as tree trunks. Currents not only move animals and plants around the ocean, but also redistribute heat and nutrients. Ocean currents and circulations are driven by winds and by changes in water density. If we remember that the density of the ocean is controlled by temperature and salinity, any future changes to winds, temperature, or salinity will impact ocean circulations. However, changes will likely not be uniform and may in fact be quite episodic. Any changes in ocean currents will have major impacts with regards to the connectivity of populations and impacts on ocean migrants, with the potential to reshape entire communities. So how do we measure changes in the ocean? It is much more challenging than in the atmosphere. To take the ocean's temperature, we need sensors at enough locations and at sufficient depths to track changes throughout the entire ocean. To measure ocean currents, one approach is to moor a current meter in the ocean, so that the current is assessed at one fixed location. A second approach is to track a free floating drifter placed in the ocean. Since 2006, the ARGO program of autonomous profiling floats has provided near global coverage of the upper 2,000 meters of the ocean. We have seen that just like the atmosphere, ocean circulations move heat towards the poles. However, because the oceans have a large heat capacity and are more dense than air, the currents move more slowly and store a lot of heat. The ocean heat content tells us how much heat is stored in the oceans. Just like the global atmospheric temperature, the ocean heat content has been increasing. The increase in ocean heat content observed since 1992 in the upper 2 kilometers of the ocean is about 2,000 times the total net generation of electricity by US utility companies in the past decade. That is a lot of energy. In fact, during 2015 and 2016, the heat stored in the upper 2 kilometers of the world ocean reached a new record high during the 57 years we have observations. The Atlantic Meridional Overturning Circulation, or AMOC, has a northward flow of warm, salty water in the upper layers of the Atlantic, the Gulf Stream, and a southward flow of colder water in the deep Atlantic. The AMOC, which includes part of the thermohaline circulation, affects the global climate system by transporting large amounts of heat. It impacts climate over North America and Western Europe, rainfall in the African monsoon, and even hurricanes in the Atlantic. A key region for the AMOC is the North Atlantic. Here, water is very dense. It is cold and it is salty. When sea ice forms, the salt is left behind in the water, so the water becomes more saline. This dense water sinks, forming North Atlantic deep water and driving the circulation. Recent research has shown a slowdown or weakening in the AMOC circulation of around 15% since the mid-20th century. This slowdown is associated with reduced northward heat transport, as well as a northward shift of the Gulf Stream. It also may have affected the weather in Europe. Climate models project that the strength of the AMOC will continue to decrease in the 21st century, associated with increases in greenhouse gas concentrations. Climate change will increase temperature, precipitation, river runoff, melting of the Greenland ice sheet, and melting of Arctic sea ice, which will increase the amount of fresh water flowing into the critical deep water formation areas in the North Atlantic. Warmer and fresher water is less dense, so without the sinking water in the North Atlantic driving the circulation, the AMOC slows down, like a traffic jam of water. The AMOC is one of the well-documented tipping points of the climate system. The complete shutdown or collapse of the AMOC can be thought of as a low-probability, high-risk event. Currently, no comprehensive climate models project that the AMOC will abruptly weaken or collapse in the 21st century, although the possibility cannot be entirely excluded. As the AMOC is so important to the climate system, a potential collapse would have severe consequences around the world, although it won't be like what you see in the movies. The AMOC isn't the only ocean circulation that is impacted by climate change. We've heard about the importance of coastal upwelling along the eastern boundaries of oceans, like in California and Peru. Coastal upwelling fuels high productivity, supporting vast and diverse marine populations. Although their surface area is only 2% of the global oceans, eastern boundary current systems provide upward of 20% of wild marine capture fisheries. The reported increases in coastal winds as the climate changes, although subtle and spatially variable, support intensification of upwelling in eastern boundary current systems. The Arctic Ocean is the smallest of the world's five major oceans, but is undergoing major changes due to climate change. Most notably, of course, is the dramatic reduction in sea ice cover. The opening of the Arctic and the Northwest Passage has important implications for shipping and military operations. But if the sea ice extent continues shrinking, winds will move the open waters and may mix the ocean in ways it hasn't circulated before. Suddenly, recreational cruising, deep sea fishing, and other Arctic Ocean transport become possible. The implications of climate change on ocean circulations and currents are widespread. A warmer and fresher North Atlantic is weakening the Atlantic meridional overturning circulation, which has numerous climate, societal, and commercial impacts. Changing currents, whether caused by increased temperatures, reduced salinity, or increased winds, impact marine communities through altered upwelling of nutrients and changes to migration and drifting patterns. Oceanographers are continuing to actively measure and model ocean heat content, circulation, and marine ecosystems in order to effectively manage and adapt to climate change.